I played myself.
So let me just brief cap that then. Sitting order, Alex, Saya, Mishka on Saya and Kozar's legs. Kozar, accepting. Family. Lovely. Nice.
Weird,
I was going to issue a flood warning. Thanks.
Such haiku.
I'm
much
not going
well.
Outside. Yeah, so Odor Tom and Astraev, you guys are also present. Alex, child. Yes? This figure, the outsider, this. My apologies. You've done so much for us. Our new friends discussed. Have you seen any such person? I'm going to need a better description. A figure charging around in the woods?
Saya is the only one that's possibly actually seen this guy. Or gal.
She's giving you the best description she has.
Yeah. So...
I must apologize. I have not seen. I mean, there are many creatures that dwell in the woods. So,
have you seen any? I don't know, leavings of persons or like tracks that you don't recognize when you're coming back.
No, none at all. Well, it is something. The hanging tree clears the land around it after it
that's true.
Finishes, so no tracks are ever left, even not even by us.
Oh, is Garth missing? If anyone else can think of anything, feel free to ask, because I can't.
Up to you guys. All of you as a group.
I'm thinking, but I'm bad at investigating. Which is also, that is both Taryn and Suma.
You build the perfect character. One you can relate to so infinitely.
Has anyone from your village gone missing that you can't account for?
Alex just looks out at her up. No,
don't. We've only this. No one has gotten caught by the hanging tree in quite a long time, and everyone else is always here, or die of assorted causes.
Except for Abranov.
Well, we know we've accounted for Abranov. He comes... Well, he's not come back in a while, but he used to come back regularly.
And there's no one else you can think of left in similar manner?
No. Oh, none that I know of.
Insight.
Roll insight.
Thinking emoji.
How did you know, old man?
as he is telling the truth, like, as far as he's, you know, aware of it, like, already through it, honestly, it's a small village, an immensely small village. He is the So, people dying, going, is... You notice it pretty quickly. So, the information he has, it's immensely easy to gather, and it's easy to just account for. So, yeah.
Did I ever say what the warden ever, like, wore?
He wore a den?
Hold up. Yeah, no.
Don't worry.
Yeah, hold up. Oh, my sheet's closed. Need to bring that up. Yep. Let's see.
Oh,
am I dead yet?
You're devolving, I think, a bit.
Damn, that's two failed. Let's go.
Devolving.
You're devolving.
It's going for caveman stats.
Saya herself does. She herself hasn't really gotten the best glimpse at him. Like, it's not exactly a good lighting system they have down there.
She knows there was a humanoid figure.
And she knows it's a humanoid figure, and she remarks that as, like, everything that moves in the place causes, like, this trudging and crystal clattering. It is, like, multiplicatively so for this warden of sorts. Crystal grinding is cracking against one another, the sound of metal and stuff like such.
That would rule out any potential new or recently made enemy.
And Alex, you haven't heard any noises like this anywhere around the tree or around the town.
Something like rocks grinding against one. Oh.
Rocks, similar metal clanging.
I take out one of the crystal fragments that I saved and I show it to them.
He holds out a hand to receive it and then. Oh, he examines it.
I ping it with the hilt of a dagger.
Ding, ding. At that, he's. Maybe? Can you do that again?
Ding. Sorry, my voice is breaking.
It's fine.
Ding.
Do we have another shard of crystal that we could tap the crystals against?
I believe you all have a lot of shards of crystals. We got a powder of it.
We got so many rocks.
Attempt that, like, clack two of them together, grind them next to each other.
It's like hitting like a flint and steel. It's like hitting flint and steel, but like both pieces ring and resonate.
A vine from the tree. That'll.
You do a vine from the pale hanging trees down below.
I've heard this sound before. He gives back the shirt. What was it though?
Yeah, he just is like thinking. He's like.
You're asking him to find like a random, very specific point of memory across like all the time. So he's sort of floundering on it.
Just close your eyes.
I've heard this, but I do not know where. Yeah.
Close your eyes and focus on the sound and see if just images pop up. Should I buy some cheddar? Let's go.
It's not actually bad advice. It's
Okay.
Try and gauge your senses, smells, sounds.
Can I see one of the pieces back?
Sure.
And he gets up and he goes over to the stone fire pit, and then he hits the crystal against the stone. It's not as high pitched as like metal hitting it or crystal hitting it. It's a bit more dull. This is what I've heard. He just keeps tapping it.
All right, so crystal and stone, it's something. What about the smell of citrus?
The smell of citrus.
Yes.
Well, that is probably what we use to get near the tree.
But do you smell it in... No, you would just smell like it when you... Fuck.
Are there any stony areas around here?
Yes, many. There are many older ruins from the old days of the town. Right, Othersdorf?
So you were paying attention.
In pieces, yes. But...
pieces that count?
I am not an expert. He just gestured to Othersdorf.
As Alex says... There are times for when Porta cursed. Town had quite the stone structures. You will see them show up, bits, pieces, even jagging out of the ground. You will see them all around. You just need look.
Is it possible that one of these jutting ruins is where you could have heard that sound?
If it is crystal hitting stone and this creature is made of crystal, then I would say that is yes.
Then it stands to reason that there are other points of entry other than the well into this cavernous system, which means that whatever is down there could be watching you on the surface as well.
ominous being.
So what are we gonna do?
Go back down there and kill the warden.
I approve.
Alright. Do we want to try exploring the ruins to see if there's any, I don't know, evidence of...
It's not like Kaer Morhen or something.
Right.
Like, it's not like there's standing structures of ruins left. It's more like bits, pieces, debris, fragments. Classic Witcher. But yeah.
Would you all be against me looking around to see if there are different entrances, potentially?
I can help.
Which one was that? That was
Mishka, right? Yeah. Mishka.
You know, some hidey holes.
She nods. She always loved wandering around town, didn't you? And like he ruffles her. Kozar is like, Right. That's a good point, Father. Marshall, you understand this dialect of non-muttering, or muttering and non-speak, tonal messages. It is accompanied by hand gestures, eye movements, and stuff of the sort. You've known some people like this, and have relatively learned how to translate it. What Kozar depicted there was, but we just got your mother back. So, probably not a good time to spoil the family again. To everyone else, it was just Kozar going,
Little Mishka. Just put a hand on her shoulder. Your mother may die soon. You do not know how much time you have. You should probably spend it with her.
What?
I mean, that's the most martial thing ever.
Mishka's eyes shoot open. Sai's eyes shoot open. She's not concerned about her own devas. We're not concerned that you...
What he means is you should spend time together because you have been apart for a very long time.
And, no, that is not the
and we also don't know what killing the thing down there does. Look, he's very blunt. It didn't mean anything.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, good gods, Marshall.
That's the most martial thing I've ever heard.
Classic.
Look.
I will help any way I can. For mother.
Here. Could Chetmir doodle like a... of the few places, like the key points of the town and be like, okay, draw on this map like where your spots are or where she knows of. Is that feasible?
Here's the thing about small children, there's a lot of hiding spots they have.
Yeah.
Like, she could definitely do it for you. Like, she could definitely, like, mark some of them, but she would, like, say, like,
I have many more, though.
I would not want to split you guys up a moment after your reunification, so might I suggest that you all go?
It's certainly an option.
Either that or you all stay. The choice is yours.
Because I just grunt and nod.
Alex stands up. This
there's a lot of ruins around. Mishka is always a delving sort, honestly, so this might take a while. It is late.
That's true. Should we wait for the next day?
What do you suppose you would find?
You're entirely right. I think that was more just like everyone, right?
Okay.
What would you find that would stop the warden from growing more hanging trees?
It could potentially be exits that are set up in a way that if he is defeated, then trees escape that way, or they spread spores or something like that. It's a small chance, but it's possible. But you're right, there's not much of anything to be gained from doing that aside from possibly preventing a very small, dangerous aspect.
Perhaps we defeat this warden, and this is a good job for the seekers to have to. Because we have a date to Duverse, if I'm not mistaken.
They're not gonna come.
They're not gonna.
She shakes her head.
Why?
They can't afford to right now.
Resources.
And
manpower.
But there's one former seeker.
She looks up at all of you. She's going to start looking down at the ground this whole time. This is me telling you this time. I'm going to scout. With or without you guys.
Where and what for?
For wherever the hell this is we're looking for. Stone ruins, entrances underground.
Don't go into them.
Please.
Please.
Well, I guess you'll have to come with me to make sure I don't.
I will.
And I got an idea. Let me see that map.
I hand it over to her.
We explored all the caverns. It's like she pulls out, or she, like, it's like, she asks for the other map, the one that you were drawing of the cavern itself, and she just begins, like, sort of laying them next to each other. We explored all of the caverns, and we didn't see anything that led to the surface other than that one point with the tree. But that's made of wood, so that can't be it. So that means, and then she
pulls more out than one cavern.
Maybe, but what I'm thinking is either we missed something, which I definitely didn't, and then she just draws like a circle, like on.
Yeah, I could just do it actually.
A circle.
Like this. So you just draws a circle. All right, fuck you too. There you go, Rotoy. Yeah, so she just draws a circle.
And then she does a similar way. And she overlines the papers next to each other and just does another circle of the same relative shape on the larger map of the town up here. One of the ways we didn't go or investigate has to have an entrance or an exit or whatever. We explored everything else. So it's one of the ways we didn't go, or there's something there we didn't see. Because, let's be honest, I wasn't exactly taking the time to investigate stuff when... Did she, like, looked at Saya? You know. So there might have been plenty that we missed. So there has to be an entrance, or exit, whatever, somewhere. In this general area. And she taps on, like, just runs a circle around the area. On the surface map, essentially. The town map. If your maps are right, which I'm having faith they are, Chedomir. If we go the distance from the well, she's basically just sort of cross like overlaying them. And it's like, if we gone this distance from the well, which we confirm this entire radius area from the well is safe, and we went in a western and northwestern direction. That means in that direction is where we're going to find our entrance. Past a certain distance.
But to what end?
We can ambush him. Although, might have heard us coming with all the shit we did down there. So maybe.
There's only one spot where we were noticeable.
I think the longer time we give him,
he has to prepare.
That's also a good point. She tucks the maps and folds them and hands them back to each other. It's up to you guys. Seekers are meant for support.
If we do find a way in,
a different entrance might provide a different perspective.
And we could potentially do pincer maneuver and surprise him. Gain some sort of advantage that way. And yes, Marshall, you do get to punch things and stab things and hit things with a hammer.
If we spend all this time finding all these ruined exits and entrances, then the plague for Dovra spreads over and kills everyone. What good is...
It's so we're prepared and don't just rush into a fight and get murdered by something because we didn't know what we were fighting.
Because the other alternative is that we just rush in and all get killed, and then once again, the plague kills everybody.
Mira holds my hand. Hmm. How about this? We'll go back down there. And we don't have to just find this guy. I feel like he's going to find us, but... We can investigate underground for exits, too.
Instead of having a whole area above ground, we have limited paths.
Exactly. Exactly.
Miss Saya? Yes?
Is there anything you can give us? Any information? Did you wander around down there? And Saya shakes her head. Anything at all?
Did you just wake up in that garden?
She holds up, or she asks for the map back. The underground that you had. And she holds out. With Saya's information, she will remark that she came down this Severn path. This is really shit, but bear with me here.
It does.
And that it is essentially a dead end. And that she didn't see anything.
Alright.
It was something of a hidey hole. Mm-hmm. Amidst all of us.
So if there is a potential path, it would be going...
Mira's like... Through the ground. Hmm. Mira marks like... One path for down. One path eliminated. So there's only one way we can go for investigation.
And that way is almost assuredly where... The warden...
The boss is. She could say boss. He's the boss of the place.
Yeah, no, you're not wrong.
I think that's expert opinion. How much time do you think this will...
I looked at Mira. With limited region, maybe half an hour, an hour, something like that.
If we rush back down there, it took us like 40 minutes to get back up here? From the very, very depths of it? Takes the same amount of time back. Actually, no, we can go faster because we're not escorting anyone. Mm-hmm. So, 20 minutes down. Investigating... The tree room. There's something. There has to be something in there.
Downside is it's guarded by a bunch of hanging trees.
Where else would you guard something?
I'm not saying that's not right.
All the walls are overgrown of vines. So, what if there's something behind them? There's hanging trees.
When you're defenses. When you're going through someone's home, looking for things they don't want found, look in the last place they would put it.
Hmm.
I don't think anyone would want you to find some house if they weren't there.
So there's only one way to find out.
The water that goes through that room comes from somewhere. Maybe following that will lead up somewhere.
I will say that, going a northwestern and western path across a certain distance, you are, underneath the river at certain points. Not, it's entirely underneath the river, not like that, but at certain points it does, the river would overlap on top of it.
So I think, at the very least, we're going to head back down to the tree room and see if there's something down there.
You can get that fight in, huh, Marshall? I'll be sure not to steal your glory. She gives you a wink.
You've been making preparations. I will do something. Gets up. Nod. He's the room.
He really grows on you, doesn't he?
Might be time to add Lumberjack to his title.
Lumberjack the Moatides?
I think he can make it work.
Probably.
But yeah, he's a weird one, but...
He grows on you.
Yeah. Something, something, tree joke, something, something.
I wasn't even thinking of that, and now I think I am worse because of it. Thanks. Thanks, Jeremy. I appreciate
that
it.
First.
Yeah. Jeremy does finger guns. What are guns? I would also, since I have a second, I would give Aldric one of Connor's toxins and Seema and Danaway.
Toxins?
Yes, Connor gave me toxins at the beginning of this trip that I never found. What did...
Chedimir, what is this? What does it do?
You poke, you put it on your sword, you poke a thing, it makes it hurt. It's poison.
Lasts for a certain amount of around or hits either.
In the back of your mind, you just feel some shame.
This is literally this is why I waited for Marshall to leave the fucking room. I was like, wait for it, okay.
Let me just check here. Talk.
It's on my sheet if you want to look at it.
It lasts 4 melee attacks.
Yeah. And they...
Thank you, Chedimir. But
no, yours don't last 4 melee attacks. His do.
No, they do not. What'd you say, Fred?
4 attacks for a lifetime of regret.
Thank you, Chedimir, but I think I will pass. I don't... It would feel weird for me to apply poison to Vanadis for different reasons.
You know, when you say it like that, I do not question your judgment on that in the slightest.
Thank you, Chedimir. I'm going to poison my sword real, real good.
I don't have a talking sword, so hand it over. Danaway remarks.
Thank you, Seema, for making me not feel useless.
all the other ungrateful people.
I'm not out here looking to death.
Is that just going to be an extra plus one, or?
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, okay.
The gift. So, remember how I rolled a massive shit ton of dice for the Seema assassination attempt?
Ooh.
Yeah, so that's what happens when you have a professional alchemist just supplying you with toxins, is just that, oh, here's like an additional 5D something.
To be fair, I'm going to be 100% honest. At the time when you gave them to me, you said they do 2d6 plus 5 damage.
When was it? Wait, this was at the very beginning of the trip?
This was at the beginning. We didn't even take off.
Oh, yeah, Connor didn't trust you at that point.
Exactly. He was just like, here's some shitty ones that I made. Have fun.
Here's my reject pile.
Mm-hmm. That'd probably do 2d... it would probably be 2d6 plus his... and so plus 5.
And I accidentally mixed my urine in these, you can have it. They might.
Hey, that's a good way to poison your enemy, tank.
Yes, urine.
I hear that, rat.
I approve of this recurrence impression. It's very good. But yeah, so 2d6. 2d6 plus 5.
Boom jams.
As opposed to like 4d6 plus something. Yeah.
Remember, 4 hits. 5d6.
For 4 hits. 4 successful hits.
Mm.
Yeah. So.
I don't care if I can put a fireball on my weapon.
I mean, to
be honest, a bottom level fireball is probably worth.
What if you could wield a fireball as your weapon?
Yes. A flail fireball is just literally just a ball of fire.
The problem is, you smack a dude, it explodes in your face.
That would be a dope magic weapon, first off.
Would be?
I will put it into the game at some point.
That's a fiend. That's a fiend or double weapon. They're immune to fire damage. Right, boom.
Yeah, that's flail definitely like a...
Flail of literal fireball.
Awesome. That sounds like a fiend pack warlock weapon all the way.
Alright, so it's in my notes now. Don't you worry.
That'd be so cool.
That'd be pretty dope.
Anyways.
So, we're gonna expedite some things.
Yes.
Yes. So you guys go back down.